In an exclusive interview with Today on One Sports, Namibia Football Association Super League chairperson Jackie Gertse announced that the Women's Super League, which was initially planned to kick off in March 2020, is scheduled to kick off early in 2021. Apart from building up to the new season, there will be a pre-season tournament scheduled to take place in November 2020.
Our meeting, technical meeting, has now created a pathway to show that the coaches of, because all 12 clubs were represented, that has been given the go-ahead to be part of the league. And as you know, this is not a regional league, this is a premiership. 67% of the players that completed last season in the Super League are top players from all over the country. In that regard, the consultancy that we have now appointed will then look at how to empower the league financially. And the Football Association, under the new leadership, is also looking at making sure that the executive and the secretary general, they also go out there and find more money for the league. The league, we believe, should be in a better position to be able to provide better for members, and the members then provide better for their players, and the whole setup of COVID-19, taking care of the medical side of things and so on. So the league is really in a better space, although it has been postponed and we couldn't kick a ball on the field. At this stage, to announce the league date is not possible. One thing we are sure about, although we didn't announce the date, is the fact that we will not kick off the league in 2020. We will kick it off as early as February next year, but the date, exact date in February, is not yet set, and I think it's for obvious reasons. These are direct support that goes to the members of the league, the 12 clubs. It's your things like your mask, it's all your medical supplies you need for the club to be enabled to actually even train on their own venues. The league is actually taking a very big leap towards making sure that we are a little bit more organized and so on. But then also it gives us then a chance to organize a pre-season tournament this year. The pre-season tournament will then, it's open for all 12 clubs. But due to COVID-19, clubs need to confirm if they are able to participate in the tournament. That alone is the number one step to make sure that our members are ready to participate.
With the recent announcement by the Confederation of African Football that they will be introducing an annual International Women's Association Football Club competition in Africa, the CAF Women's Champions League, Gertse shared that the announcement is an encouragement for the Super League to kick off, as it will provide great exposure to women footballers and officials in the country.
So the Super League is more encouraged by the fact that your champion team will not only walk away for a small amount of money, the prices increases this season, and then there's opportunity to play the zonal playoffs before you go to the zonal final, and a zonal winner, Kosovo winner, goes to the CAF final. So that is, it's a long process of playing, which means more games. More games means more exposure for your top players in the league, and then more exposure for your coaches that are in the league, more exposure for your referees, because your top referees in the Super League are your FIFA 4 referees, ladies, and some of the guys that are in the NFA or at CAF level. Those people also get a chance to be selected to go to the zonal CAF Champions League, which is COSAFA. They have a chance, if you do well, to be selected to go to the final. So the CAF Women Champions League, they just bring a different image in terms of identity of the women's game, more media coverage, players more identified in terms of, you know, if you're top goal scorer in the Women's Super League, there's already an attraction from other clubs in the region of Kosovo that wants to maybe have you for their team because of the chance to play in the Champions League.
Gertse further assured that the budget for the league has been submitted during the ExCo meeting and are awaiting a response from the NFA and the Secretary General.